the second student that we hosted, we picked at the last minute in August. And we knew that she was going to be coming to us from Lebanon, and that she was vegan, and that she was also Muslim. And we thought, she seems like a great kid. Let's have her come and be part of our family. And when she came, she integrated into the family. She was happy, easygoing, funny, friendly. And one of the things that she would do is go and pray 5 times a day. And she had her own room, and she could just sneak away and go pray. And often we never even knew that she was doing that. She would just disappear for a little while and then come back. And we didn't really have a lot of conversations about her religion initially in the beginning, and we just let her live her life as she needed to. But as the year went on, she started leaving her door open when she prayed. And one day, my 7-year-old son went in her room while she was praying and sat on the bed and watched her, and very quietly, didn't make a noise. And I walked by and I saw him in there, and at first I was like, oh no, he's disturbing her. But then I noticed that he was just observing her. And she continued with her prayers, and Matthew just watched. And I thought, what an incredible experience for him. And then he asked her some questions, and she answered them. And they walked out of the room and continued on with their day. And that is a moment for me that I could never have given my child, to be able to experience that part of another culture. And that's part of the reason that I host for YFU.